Hey, you! Yeah, you. Hey, stop what you're doing. Whether you're a hatch or a hatch this, I want you to stop what you're doing. Do you understand or know what the oldest creed of the penguin clan is in the Antarctica? Huh?
Never bathe in hot oil and biscuit?
No, no. Huh? No, Rico, that's the Walrus Credo. It's never swim alone. And we've stuck strict to this creed ever since we found the youngest one on this team, a private. When I saw a private on that Antarctica, in that very Antarctican day, I didn't really know what it was. And you know, we saw this egg, and we didn't know if it was in a healthy state to hatch or whatnot. But we managed to escape from this mindless march of penguins, and I'm like, where are we marching to? And they're like, I don't know, and they're just okay with that. But me and my brothers, Kowalski and Rico, we decide to break free of this mindless cycle and go out and about to see what other things the world, what other wildness the world has to offer. And that's when, you know, we ran into the Central Park Zoo crew, that psychotic lion and his monochromatic friend, and that gorgeous hippo and that very tall spotsam giraffe. But, yeah, a long time come since we first found private, and when I first looked into those adorable eyes with that little beak and those black fins, I said to myself, if the founding of this brotherhood doesn't mean family, I don't know what does. Birds of a feather flock together. What better way is there to implement that than with the four of us, this quartet of plucky penguins? Myself, Skipper, Kowalski, Private, and Rico, the most elite of the elite spies ever hatched. We joined forces with a chic undercover organization known as North Wind. Well, it's time to break some wind. Led by highly trained, handsome, and arrogant agent Classified, I asked him what's his name. He said, it's Classified. I was like, okay, so your name is Classified. And nice to meet you, Classified. But this special interspecies task force must stop a many-tentacled villain, Dr. Otto Octavius. Nope, that's the wrong Octavius. Dr. Octavius Brine. Now, you may know me, Kowalski, Rico, and Private from the little inferior DreamWorks series in the Codex called Madagascar. The Madagascar franchise may be inferior when it comes to the other films in this DreamWorks Codex. It may have not as aged well as the likes of that smelly ogre and that monochromatic dumpling eater. But the series has had its fair share of memorable voice acting, wild silliness, and only one catchy musical number. Don't ask me what it is. I want you to figure it out, spies. The one aspect of those movies that never gets talked about enough are the Posse of Penguins, myself and my brothers. And we are usually depicted in this franchise as on and off again associates of the Central Park Zoo crew. And we normally stick to our personal side missions that remain sophisticated under my personal agenda, to either assist in saving one of the animals or saving one of their own in a Mission Impossible type of fashion. And trust me, it is very sophisticated. However, there can only be one DreamWorks spinoff, and sadly, this is not it. I feel like the Penguins of Madagascar NickToon spinoff that your children's and your children's, and in translation, your hatchlings and your hatchlings' hatchlings may have watched a long time ago in the zeros. Well, in the 2010s, technically, shortly after the release or before the release of Madagascar 3. Which, I'll beg to differ that spinoff NickToon is a lot better than this one film. Let me explain, agents. So, we, the Penguins of Madagascar, our spinoff was a better alternative as it puts us in a better light with more things to do and more things to say and stay feeling like supporting characters. The reason why the Penguins of Madagascar spinoff movie fails where the Puss in Boots spinoff movie succeeds is that the penguins were never as compelling as the Diablo Gato that chewed on his own air ball. Puss in Boots had quite an edge to him and the spirit of adventure inside, but this is only the byproduct of his swashbuckling reputation. Meanwhile, there was no type of outstanding element to the penguins outside of wacky espionage adventures in sense of brotherhood. Case in point. We'll be right back. In the spirit of constructive criticism, I will say, I will say that the strength of this movie is how we are reminded that Private is the best thing to happen to the Penguins, to me, Kowalski, and Rico. And the practical connections with the villain, Dr. Octavius, the other Dr. Octavius, the one that is not better than the other Dr. Octavius we all care about. But everything else otherwise falls short to inside humor and cheap puns. I mean, I could count them all, but we have a lot of things to do. So, with the 74% recommendation, Penguins of Madagascar puts its tolerable efforts into being a fun time for the chicks and hatchlings, but it belongs more into the biome of the tundra rather than the landscape of a spinoff. So I'd say there's a 65% chance, I say there's a 65% chance that you will like this movie, a 6 out of 10. Well, that was worth the price of admission. What am I, a hypocrite?
Oh, wait a second. Where's Private?
Oh, Chimichanga. That's what happens to an egg when you don't let it hatch.